Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Emma, and it's been a hot minute since we've done a video on Korean. A couple months back, I posted a video on my sustainable weekly language routine for learning Korean, and I've gotten a couple requests on showcasing how I use my Notion to aid in my note-taking. To be honest, I think my Notion is pretty simple. I'm no Notion potion master. I use some of the most basic commands, but it gets the job done. So I'll first take you through what I note take in Notion, and I'll also show you how you could set it up too, just like me, with all the commands involved, in the second half of the video.
아 근데 우리는 시작하기 전에 여러분에게 소개해드리고 싶은 사람 하나가 있습니다. 바로 하나님 여러분. 하나야, 자기소개를 한번 해주세요.
네, 안녕하세요. 저는 하나라고 해요. 저는 드럼 치는 거를 너무 좋아해요. 잘 부탁드려요. 그럼 우리 시작할까요?
In 2024, it was actually a goal of mine to finish the 서울대학교 textbook series 3 and 4, which are the intermediate levels. But as you can see here, I got through to 서울 3A, 3B, and a little bit of 4A. And this was because last year I started learning Chinese and my brain was not able to learn two languages at once. I guess I got through half of my goal last year, but I also got to learn Chinese and do a trip to China. So all is good. Anyways, let me take you through one of these chapters. Let's go for 3B, chapter 11. The way I set it up is pretty simple. I first like to start off with a checklist of things I want to get done that week so that I can cross things out and makes me feel a little bit more motivated to learn it. And this list pretty much remains the same week after week. First is to study grammar points of one chapter, complete some workbook tasks, listen to and make notes on one podcast episode, and read one short story. And the rest of the Notion page will be pretty much set up in this exact order. First, here are the grammar points and the vocab list that is introduced in my textbook chapter. Each chapter usually introduces 3 to 4 grammar points. Sometimes I need their description, sometimes I don't, but most of the time I will just type out their sample sentences that are already provided in the textbook, and at the bottom I'll probably add a couple of my own sample sentences. 멋있다면 세상에 음악의 신이 있다면 Comment down below if you know where that is from. I also bolden the grammar points themselves in each sample sentence so that it catches my attention a little bit more when I go back to review, if I do. Likewise, I also have some vocab lists on different topics that are introduced throughout the chapter. Sometimes I have the definition if I need it. Sometimes I don't and I can figure it out. Okay, so this part, 회사 안에 있는 사람들, so the people in the company, there are a lot of like different roles in the company and I get them confused from time to time. And that is why I have definitions for some of them. Now comes the podcast part. Usually I try to choose a podcast that is the same topic as whatever the textbook is that week. And that will help me re-emphasize all the new vocab that I've encountered in the grammar textbook. The topic was 회사, or company, workplace. I chose a podcast on 빨리빨리 culture, which is close enough. I insert the podcast here so I can track what I've learned. And then I type out a couple 유용한 표현들, or useful expressions. There are lots more new expressions and words I encounter in every podcast, but I only choose the most significant ones to me to write in this list. And afterwards, I type up a little summary or a little comment, and I try to use words from this useful list. So what do we have here?
한국에는 모든 게 빨리 빠르게 해야 합니다. 배달 서비스부터 대중교통을 타기까지 모두 급하게 할 일을 완성하는 습관이 있습니다. 이 버릇이 몸에 좋지 않을까봐 걱정이에요. 결국에는 이 서비스를 제공하는 사람들도 한국인이잖아요. 자기의 인생도 있어서 쉬는 시간이 분명히 필요할 것 같아요.
I
Afterwards, we have 옛날 이야기. This one is 요술 거울, the magic mirror. This is one of my great readers on Korean folk tales. And each week, I like to read one story, and then I type it out, every last thing. Again, as another round of repetition. Plus, I get to practice my typing skills, which I think one day will come in handy. I also have a 문법 section, or grammar. And I used to type in here when the grammar in the text was harder than the grammar that I was learning in the textbook itself. But these days, usually all the grammar points in the story have already been covered in my textbook series, so there's nothing that I put in 문법. Ah, okay, here we are. This is an early one. This is January 2024, so a year ago. So I had typed out a story. I think I even boldened and colored the different grammar points and new words. And I added a grammar point that was new to me. And this was when I realized that I benefited from a lot of repetition and imitation in any and all forms. So rewriting stories and passages on paper and then typing out the same stories and learned grammar on Notion. And shadowing in real-time podcasts so that I can practice moving my mouth at a certain speed, which makes it easier to practice sounds later on. So these are some of my reflections early on last year. And yeah, that is basically it for my Notion in terms of learning Korean. It is quite simple, if I do say so myself. So now onto the part where I show you how to build it yourself. If you're entirely new to Notion, let's start with a new page. We can call it Korean. Add an icon. 김치 없는데 Korean. I will add a database to keep track of all of my chapters. So every command in Notion starts with a forward slash. So you're going to forward slash database inline. I want to change layout a little bit, not showing the database title. Okay. Now we can design our template. First, I want to change this to full width. Okay. It can be chapter something. Add an icon. Add a cover. Ooh. That's a gnarly looking cover. So let's choose this cover. As for a property, I'll add a date, which is the end date of whenever I complete it, just so that I can have track of that. I'll add another property called a checkbox called complete that I can check off once I finish the chapter. And I want another one called select, and I'll call it level, in which I can add in options for whatever level I am at. 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B. Let's say those are your goals for the year. Cool. Next is the content of the page itself. I like to use a lot of callout boxes because they're easy to shift around the page if I ever need to. Plus they look clean. Every command starts with a forward slash, so forward slash callout box. I will call this my weekly checklist. Enter forward slash to-do list. This will be textbook, workbook, podcast, graded reader. Okay. Okay, now to the contents of the textbook. I will use another callout box, forward slash callout. This will be my grammar points. Usually there are four grammar points, and I like to be able to have toggle lists. I can close them down so they look a little bit more clean. So enter forward slash toggle list. And in the toggle list, I like to have bullet points so that I can type out my sample sentences, forward slash bulleted list. And because I have four of these, I will duplicate them. So duplicate, control D, duplicate, duplicate, duplicate. Now you have four toggle lists. The layout for my vocab section is basically the same thing. So I will go ahead and duplicate this whole grammar point section. So control D, which is to vocab, and then I will drag it in line with the grammar points because they are in the same section. Okay, so now that the part for the textbook and workbook is done, we're going to go to the podcast section /callout. Podcast reflections. That will be just a text box, nothing special. And then another callout box /video. That is a huge thumbnail. Let me pull it to the side right here. Okay, a little bit more manageable. So below, I'd like to have more bulleted lists /bulleted so that I can jot down new expressions. Okay, after that, I have yet another call out box. You guys know the drill by now, which is for my rated reader. Enter toggle list. This is for insert name of reading passage. And then another toggle list for new grammar points. And this will be where I type out the entire text passage. And then this is another callout box, tips, bulleted list. Yeah, and I like this because if I don't like it as a big part right there, I can drag it to the side like this. It looks kind of sparse right now, and that's just because I haven't typed out anything here. But once you type in this area, it will fill up pretty quickly. Okay, so that was our template. Let's go back. So let's say I want to add a new chapter. I want to say chapter 13, and this is part of level 2B, let's say. 거배우기다. Maybe that can be your title. Shift completion, this side. And here. And you can set this as a default. So every time you add a new page, it is the same chapter format. And that way you have a visual view of all the chapters that you want to learn. So this will be what it looks like. This is what a chapter format will look like. And this is what it looks like when it's all filled in. So I guess I've been listening to Didi for a year now. Isn't that cool? As for the way that I can set it up as part of like my yearly goal database, which I can link the video tutorial that I followed to create said yearly goal template down below because I don't actually know how to do it myself. But yeah, that is all there really is to it. I only use some simple commands such as /callout, /bulleted list, /to-do list, and /toggle list. And it gets the job done.
네, 여러분이 영상을 끝까지 봐주셔서 너무 감사하고요. 이런 내용이 유용하시면 좋을 것 같아요. 여러분 질문이 아니면 멘트가 있으시면 댓글로 남겨주셔서 감사하겠습니다. 새해 복 많이 받으세요. 우리는 다음 영상에 또 만나요. 안녕. 한나야.